Yeah.
Mr. Clark, Mr. Jensen is here to see you.
Send him in, please.
You want to see me, Mr. Clark?
Yes, Tom. Please sit down. How long have you been working in the design department?
About a month, sir.
Well, then maybe you don't know that we generally like to stick to the tried and true when it comes to novelty items. For instance, did you design this fake rubber vomit?
Yes, sir.
Well, first of all, why did you make it so big? I mean, someone wouldn't vomit this much vomit, would they?
I guess I just thought, more vomit would be funnier.
And why did you put this whole sandwich in it?
As a joke. It is a joke thing, right?
Yeah, but... Well, let's move on. Maybe you can tell me what this is.
Oh. That's the fake log through the head.
Well, I'm familiar with the arrow through the head, but a log? How would you even get a log through the head?
Well, say you were out chopping some firewood, and after you chopped a piece, you were throwing it over onto this big pile, and just then a guy walked by and it hit him in the head. That actually happened to me. That's how I got it.
Yeah, but it wouldn't go through your head, would it?
No, but that's why it's funny.
Finally, I was curious about this fake ice cube you designed. Instead of having a fly in it, it has a little tiny shrunken head. I guess I'm at a loss to understand, first of all, how a head could get this small, and then somehow get into an ice cube.
Well, to be honest with you, Mr. Clark, I really don't know. I just thought it would be scarier than a fly.
Tom, I'm sorry, but I'm afraid we're going to have to let you go. It's not quite working out.
Okay, I understand, Mr. Clark. Could I give you this cigar?
Well, thanks, Tom. That's very nice of you.
Here, let me light it for you. There.
Mmm. So, an extra powerful exploding cigar. I like it. No, I love it. Jensen, you're back on the payroll.
Oh, thanks, Mr. Clark, but I don't want to be paid in joke money.